Dismissive avoidant attachment. Understanding and loving an emotionally distant partner. Meeting your needs and nurturing closeness. Written by Janis Bryans. Narrated by Andrea Webster. Introduction. All humans want to make and keep connections with others. It is in our nature to want acceptance and support from our fellow human beings, even if we believe a relationship is detrimental, toxic, or destructive. Many of our emotions are linked to our friends, partners, and other close contacts. Remember how joyful you felt when you got into a new relationship, or how horrible it was when someone you were close to abandoned you. According to studies, we are happier when we maintain healthy relationships. Humans need to feel like they belong. But those with dismissive avoidant attachment types generally do not have a desire to be a part of a group. These individuals often do not care about having social connections or closeness in a relationship. They claim, for instance, that they feel fine living their lives without any intimate attachments and do not intend to rely on others. John Bowlby, 1907 through 1990, the British psychotherapist who sought to understand the tremendous pain of children removed from their parents, initially created the notion of attachment. Bowlby noted that children would spend an exceptional amount of time sobbing or screaming to prevent their parents from leaving or to restore their proximity to a missing parent. In the first writings of Bowlby, psychoanalysts considered these expressions to be manifestations of immature defensive mechanisms that suppress emotional pain. However, Bowlby observed that such expressions were prevalent in many mammalian species and speculated that such behavior could have evolutionary function. Bowlby suggested the adaptive responses to separation from a primary attachment figure, someone who supports, protects, and cares, include conduct such as crying and seeking. Because human children cannot feed or protect themselves, they depend on the care and protection of older and wiser adults. Bowlby argues that children who can retain their connection to an attachment figure through attachment behavior are more likely to thrive into adulthood. In connection theory, the attachment behavior system is an essential idea because it links the development of people with the control of emotions and personality. While Bowlby concentrated primarily on understanding the nature of child-caregiver connection, he felt that attachment characterized human experience from the cradle to the tomb. However, only in the mid-1980s did researchers consider the prospect that attachment processes could take place in adulthood seriously. Hazen and Shaver, 1987, were two of the first scholars to study Bowlby's ideas on romantic context. According to them, the emotional relationship between adult love partners is partly dependent on the same mechanism of motivation, the behavioral connection system, which creates an emotional link between children and their careers. The idea that romantic ties might be relationships of attachment profoundly influences modern study into close relations. This theory has at least three critical implications. First, if adult romantic relationships are attachment connections, then the same differences in adult relationships that Mary Ainsworth noted in child-caregiver relationships should be noted. We could expect certain adults, for instance, to feel safe in their relationship, to feel certain that if needed, their partner will be there for them. In contrast, we should anticipate other adults in their relationships to be insecure. For example, some unsafe people worry that others will not fully love them and can get angry and upset easily when their attachment requirements go unfulfilled. Others with an avoidant attachment style might not appear to be too concerned about close relations and not to be too dependent on others. Secondly, if adult romantic relationships are affected by attachment styles, the way adult relationships function should be comparable to the way children's careers work. In other words, similar elements facilitating infant exploration, i.e., a caregiver, should support adult exploration, i.e., having a responsive partner. Likewise, the elements that make an attachment attractive to children, i.e., reactance and availability, are the types of factors that adults should find appealing in romantic partners. In short, individual attachment characteristics should influence the relationship and personal functioning in maturity in the same way in infancy. Whether an adult is safe or insecure in their relationships often depends on their experience with their primary caregivers. A safe child tends to trust that people will be there for him, since he has experienced that in the past. Once a youngster has established these expectations, he or she will often search for relationship experiences that match those expectations. This should, according to Bowlby, foster continuity in patterns of attachment throughout life. Although a person's attachment pattern may shift when his or her relationship experiences do not meet his or her expectations. If we consider that adult relationships are attachment relationships, children who are safe as children usually grow up to have safe and secure romantic relationships. The purpose of this book is to present a quick review of adult attachment research history, key theoretical principles, and a sample of some of the study findings. This book is created for people who want to understand adult attachment studies, specifically the dismissive avoidant attachment type. In addition, this book will also help people with dismissive avoidant attachment style and their partners to learn to respect each other and keep their love and intimacy alive. Attachment styles and the internal attachment working model. In terms of parenting, the attachment hypothesis is certainly among the most heavily researched of concepts. An infant's early bond with their mother shapes their future interactions, including romantic ones. Parents unwittingly impact how their child will respond to certain scenarios. Parents have a plethora of roles. They educate, train, and guide their children, instill discipline in them, and make sure they visit the dentist. They impact children without even knowing it. It's important to be a loving, supportive, safe, and reliable presence for the child. This causes people to become attached. Mothers who are aware of and sensitive to their child's needs provide their infant with a solid solution to start exploring the world without fear. This is because they provide comfort when the baby returns. Their ability to maintain consistent support for their children keeps them from fear, so long as parents can raise them well. Trust begins to develop in childhood, influencing relationships in the future. Even at 6 months of age, a child can already predict their parents' response to their unhappiness. As a result, they are already adjusting their behavior to suit those answers better. When they have had pleasant encounters with caregivers throughout their early years, a child will grow to believe that others will treat them well. Ainsworth defined three different types of attachment. Later studies introduced a fourth. These are secure attachment, anxious insecure attachment, avoidant insecure attachment, and disorganized insecure attachment. What is secure attachment? Secure attachment occurs when care providers are available, sensitive, responsive, and accepting. Securely attached parents know when to provide comfort and security to their children and give them the liberty to go out and explore their surroundings. Parents tend to support their children's activities by cheering and helping their kids whenever necessary. As a result, the youngster learns that they can get assistance while expressing negative emotions. Children who have healthy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.